Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's episode of It's News to Me. I'm your host, Laurie Melbourne. This week, we will be highlighting important events happening right here in our community. BatFest, October 27th, 2018. BatFest is Batavia's annual Halloween-themed family event attracting over 2,500 ghouls. BatFest free family fun includes downtown trick-or-treating, pumpkin bowl, contests, bat art, and games. BatFest stories and songs, Halloween parade, monster mash, dance lessons, and a pet costume contest, including even a marshmallow shooting range. Check with Batavia Main Street online at downtownbatavia.org for all the details. On the topic of Halloween, what do you think is the most popular candy in Illinois for 2018? Reporting from Batavia Patch, leading at the pole position this year is Kit Kat, according to candystore.com. Batavia Patch reports that candystore.com, a bulk candy delivering service, gathered 11 years of data to determine the three most popular Halloween candies in each state. The company says its results also depended on candy manufacturers and distributors to help verify its conclusions. In Illinois, following Kit Kat was Sour Patch Kids for second, and Snickers claimed the third spot. The top 10 most popular Halloween candies in America are Skittles, M&M's, Snickers, Reese's Cups, Starburst, Candy Corn, Hot Tamales, Hershey's, Tootsie Pops, and Jolly Ranchers. I'm not sure what my pick is, probably Hershey's or M&M's. My advice, make sure to get the candy you like best because you know, just in case there's any leftovers. Now, let's go to the park bench. Thank you, Sharon. Batavia Around the Block and Business Nuggets are brought to you in partnership with Batavia Neighbors Magazine. The much-anticipated Geneva Women's Club 44th Annual Holiday Arts and Crafts Show is just around the corner. On Sunday, November 11th, family, friends, and neighbors are invited to shop for a great cause, benefiting local Fox Valley charities. Traditionally, this event draws several thousand visitors, and with over 100 different crafters and handmade goods, there are countless gift ideas for every holiday list. The delicious baking goods sale, raffle for a variety of gift baskets, plus delicious breakfast and lunch items are sure to round out a great day for all and benefit local area philanthropic programs. The event is from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. at Geneva High School at 416 McKinley Avenue. Admission is $5 per person. Children under 12 and under are free. Geneva Women's Club is a non-for-profit philanthropic women's organization founded in 1940, dedicated to improving the lives of women, children, and families in the Fox Valley area. While supporting the community, the club offers members volunteer and leadership opportunities through fundraising, community outreach, and social events. Heritage Prairie Farm in Elburn will be hosting their Artisan Craft and Food Fair November 10th and 11th. The fair is free to enter and you can shop from 50 local vendors, featuring items such as jewelry, baked goods, artwork, decor, tea, coffee, soaps, and accessories. This event is sure to be fun. Heritage Prairie Farm is located at 2N308 Brundage Road in Elburn. Now, let's check in with Patricia Leonard at the Batavia Public Library. Thank you, Patricia. Chicago Ballet Conservatory, under the direction of Linda Cunningham, founder of State Street Dance in Geneva, will present a world-class production of The Nutcracker at the Hemmons Cultural Center, featuring the Elgin Symphony Orchestra led by Stephen Squires, resident conductor and professional dancers and actors from all around the world, on December 1st and 2nd. Director Cunningham, or Miss Linda as she's known in the dancing world, has captivated this reimagined holiday classic filled with all of the traditional elements you've come to love and embellished with delightful surprises that are sure to enchant. Professional guest artists are Alex Hamoudi, a soloist with American Ballet Theatre, Abigail Simon, American Ballet Theatre and Joffrey Ballet, Roger Hendricks Simon, veteran actor and director of stage and screen, Roni Xavier, Bolshoi, Brazil. A special treat will be when world-class prima ballerina Abigail Simon and her father, Roger Hendricks Simon, as the Drosselmeyer, will appear on stage together for the first time ever. Roger is an accomplished actor, appearing in several Oliver Stone films and much more. Roger also owns one of the most reputable acting schools in New York City, the Simon Studio. In addition to the global performers, attendees will be seeing local talent performing, including John Schweitzer, Denise Zabel, Mary Jo Pera, Jaylene Cadle, Susanna Hite, Chris and Phil Pasterick, and Laurie Milbourne. Yes, me. I have the honor to be the dance partner with Roger Hendricks Simon as he assumes the role of the Drosselmeyer. Tickets and info are available through Chicago Ballet Conservatory, online at cbcnutcracker.com, or by calling 630-893-1444. In other news, if you are a registered United States citizen, don't forget to vote on Tuesday, November 6th, at your local polling center. Now, let's go over to BPS Learning Curve. Changes are ahead for the Batavia City Council, with three aldermen deciding not to seek re-election in the April 2nd, 2019 election, according to the Kane County Chronicle. The 4th, 5th, and 7th ward will be left with vacancies. If you are interested, nominating petitions for aldermanic candidates are available at Batavia City Hall, 100 North Island Avenue. The paperwork with petition signatures may be filed no earlier than December 10th. The deadline is December 17th. Detailed information for candidates is available on the city website homepage. The City of Aurora, Illinois Animal Care and Control is asking everyone to please adopt and don't shop. You can visit City of Aurora Animal Care and Control for reduced adoption rates on dogs during the month of October. Animal Control is partnering with four area shelters to get dogs out of shelters and into homes. All dogs 6 months and older will have an adoption fee of only $75. The adoption fee includes spay, neuter, vaccinations, and microchip. You can view the dogs Monday through Saturday, 12 to 4:30 p.m. Contact the City of Aurora for more details. That's all we have for today, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of It's News to Me. Most of our programming is viewable online at mybatv.com or on YouTube under the username BATV1017. Be sure to like our Facebook page to stay up to date on the station's current happenings. Thanks again for watching. I'm Laurie Milbourne, and that's news to me.